Okay, Eindrücke von der Intertabak 2015 in Dortmund. Wir haben ja gerade einen jungen Burschen aufgegabelt, Daniel Marshall, und den wollen wir jetzt befragen zu seinen tollen Zigarren. Hi Daniel, it's me Sebastian. We would like you to present the classic version of the Daniel Marshall cigars.
My great pleasure, Sebastian, and welcome to everybody to Starkest Cigar. And I'm more than honored to be here in Germany, in Dortmund at the show, and to be represented by such a great company like Kohlhaus and Kopp. They do a great job to bring the finest cigars to you here in Germany. And we have created a cigar in 1996, working with a cigar maker, fifth generation cigar maker called Manuel Quesada, who is very famous for making Romeo and Juliet from the Dominican Republic. And I became friends with all the greatest cigar makers because Cigar Aficionado has big smokes. And all over the U.S., we used to travel together like one gang and go to dinners and drinks afterwards. So I got to meet everyone. And I was making humidors since 1983, started making humidors for Alfred Dunhill. And so the cigar extension to our brand came about because customers would see us at the big smokes. Thousands of people would come by and say, Daniel, you make the best humidors in the world. Why don't you come out with a cigar? And because your humidors are of such high quality, we know that if you made a cigar, it would have commensurate kind of quality and idea behind it. And I was saying, oh, I'm too busy with humidors. I don't want to do a cigar. No, 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 no. And then, you know, sometimes you say no to the best ideas that are given to you, and the best ideas come from our customers. So I got to Manuel and I said, listen, I know we're in the height of the cigar boom. We cannot make enough cigars. You can't even make me the boxes, but that's no problem. I'll make the boxes. Can you do me a big favor? Can you make me a cigar? And here's the kind of taste I want. Creamy, chocolatey, rich, little espresso taste in it, and some cinnamon and a little spice. But I want it smooth and age-worthy. And you know what? Charge me whatever you want, as much as you want, because I want a perfect cigar. I want it to be fermented forever, age forever, use the most expensive tobacco, spare no expense. I can afford to say it because I make my money with the humidors. So I really wanted to come up with a cigar that I could be super proud of, and also put with our humidors that go to all the greatest cigar smokers of the world and real connoisseurs of luxury. And I'm known for affordable luxury. So that's always been my goal. And working with Manuel Quesada, we worked a deal out where we traded. I would make him humidors for packaging of his cigars, and he made me cigars in a time where, believe me, he could not even make enough cigars for himself. But that's an example of friendship and also of the bonds that cigars give when you're friends with somebody who smokes cigars. And I know all of you that are listening and all of you that love cigars know what I'm talking about. It's the family of the cigar, and I love it when we all can get together and share, no matter what country we're from, what age bracket we're in, what income bracket we're in, we're all one because of the cigar. And I call it the modern day campfire that we get to enjoy when we sit down and smoke a cigar with somebody. So the cigars came about in 97, and I was constantly looking, how do we improve them? How do we find the best tobaccos all over the world? And when Manuel Quesada introduced me to Nestor Plasencia, a really fantastic fifth generation cigar maker, one of the world's famous, I think, in Nicaragua, I said, let's do that, because that's really the flavor profile I want to add to our next version of cigars, a really Cuban-esque kind of taste. I wanted something, though, that had that strength, had the body, but very smooth and very creamy, with no bite. And so we found, I did the research and found out how to achieve that. So not only using 5-year-old Cuban seed tobacco, from the best fields, working with the most talented cigar makers in the world, but then aging the cigar. And we believe in box aging the cigar 1 year at least from the time it's made. And that's really, to me, when a cigar should be judged as born. Just like with our children, that's the age that it starts. So when you smoke a Daniel Marshall cigar, it's 5-year-old tobacco, and then it's box aged for 1 year, and it's age-worthy tobacco. So over the years, it will continue to get better and better and better, in my opinion. But it's something I'm very proud about, and we put it in our humidors, and we've had great success in Germany and Europe and Asia and all over the world. So it's something I would like everybody to try, and give me your opinion of the cigar and let me know what you think, because of course the best way to judge a cigar is your personal connection to it and your feeling for it. But just know that I am on that constant mission and constant search to create and make the best cigar in the world that I possibly can do.
Okay, thanks Daniel. We will still talk about the gold one. Ja, ich sag vielen Dank, Daniel. Und ja, kurz, eine ganz kurze Übersetzung vielleicht noch. Daniel hat früher Humidore hergestellt, sehr hochwertige Humidore in den USA. Wurde dann immer wieder gefragt, warum machst du nicht tolle Zigarren? Er hat dann Manuel Quesada kennengelernt und Cusano und hat mit ihm und dann auch mit Nestor Plasencia zusammen eine Zigarre hergestellt, bei der ihm sehr wichtig war, dass die sehr weich ist, cremige Aromen hat und komplex bei vielen, vielen verschiedenen interessanten Aromen. Und das ist ihm auf jeden Fall mit dieser klassischen Daniel Marshall Serie gelungen. Und ja, wir freuen uns auf diese Zigarren.